All right, guys, welcome back. We are on episode 20, finally. So as you can see, I've been playing on my other one. I'm at 73%, almost done with Wisconsin. A few extra little missions to do. But we're going to Amandra. We're going to get this map done. We're going to finish the plane, three parts. And see where we're at. Maybe get rid of some of these trailers. I said I was going to come in and do the trailers, but I didn't get to it. I was busy on my other one. We'll see where we're sitting after we get done with the plane mission. There's a way to cheat this, and I'm going to show you that. Well, cheat is a strong word. Make things a little bit easier. For some reason, this PC or PS4 version seems to take forever to load. That's all right. We'll get right to it. We won't be jumping maps. I just have trailers on this map. So hope everybody had a great week. It is now Saturday morning. Alright, here we are. So, what do we have over here? What do we have vehicles? We have a trailer, which is here. Where is... Here we go, we got this truck. Need this truck. All the other missions are done, I believe. I gotta double check that when I get to the airport. But, sometimes I cut down through right here. It can be dangerous if you're hauling other loads. I found out in a quick hurry that you don't want to take logs down there because you will tip over. Again, we will be getting to the logging eventually. There really isn't that much to that, I mean, to be honest. Just hauling logs. It's a lot of running around. And again, I recommend going around the edges. If you go across that middle, you're screwed. You're going to break through. Stay on the ice chunks here. On the breakup. You can go left or right around the island. There's plenty of room either way. Airport. Then we can get into flooded foothills. Alright, so we're gonna need this big ass trailer. Trailers to get rid of. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Well, these are you can't do any of these two anyway, so like 8 trailers. Maybe not too bad. Alright. So these are all done. Oh no. These are almost done. These are some logging missions, so logs. So we got a star in the sky. Alright, white flatbed trailer to the airplane wreck. So, we have to go here. Now, there are many ways to get there. My suggestion is to follow the airport. I'll put some dots down in case you're trying to do this at home. We gotta click the button. 1, 2, and I go right along the edges of these trees. This is my route. You can go any way you like. Right in here, I turn and go down toward the beach. It's a big trailer, so you gotta take a wide turn. I'm gonna go down, down, down. I'm gonna go back up this way. Through here. Right up through here. Now you got some rocks right here, but we're gonna just make our way down around this light pole. There's a little fuel carrier trailer. We can use that to refuel if we need to. And then over to the, what do we call it? And I already have a truck over here. I think it's the one with the seismic deal on it. To be honest, I'm not sure exactly. But that's the little route we got to take. You can try to get through here. I won't recommend it. I mean, the trailer's big. You're going to get hung up. So we'll follow the dots. See how it goes. First, we're going to refuel out this trailer over here. And you only have to use this big trailer on the very first mission. This first part, where you got to take the wide body trailer or whatever to the wreckage. General, what the hell is doing? Refuel, dummy. Alright. I'm about to see how long this is going to take. good morning. Speaking of morning, let's make it morning. Now you can go over these rocks that are on the road over here on your right, but I prefer to go around them. And I honestly don't remember what trailer I have, which truck I have over there. Star in the sky. Alright, so anywhere, I put the little marker here, but yeah, anywhere you can get off of here is good. It's a big heavy trailer. It's harder to come back up than it looks. I don't know if the gravity helps. Go, but don't gotta go too fast. You'll start popping springs and tires and stuff. No, I didn't need, because I know this map or this route by heart. The only reason I did it is for y'all at home. If you're watching this and you want to figure out how the hell to get to this place, the easiest route that I've found. Maybe there's an easier one, I don't know. Maybe you can get that helicopter hot-wired and fly over and get your stuff. good evening. Ship. And then we're going to be doing trailers. We'll see where we're falling here. We'll see how quickly we can get this mission done. So you want to take this as a wide turn. Not out into the ocean and get stuck, like I just did, but a wide turn. Because this trailer is a big SOB and it doesn't like to turn very well. Which again is why I like to do this in, this is the only trip. I'm not taking it for all three trips. It's as if they made a path just wide enough for you to fit through, so. I think this is how they wanted you to go in the game. This little swampy area up here coming up on can be tricky. You gotta make sure you catch wide enough, otherwise you catch trees and get hung up. Be afraid you won't get stuck. It's not that deep. Just make your own road. Oh, that's so bad, right? Wake up! Wake up! Send the birds up after him. Gonna wake up these villagers. Can't sleep all day. It's like 7 o'clock in the morning. Get up. Wasting the day away. How about the fence, mister? Well, it took about 7 minutes to get over here. Looking at my little clock. Give or take a minute, I would say 7 to 8. Flatbed. Sweet, I have one over here. But I do need the seismic truck. Oh, I might be able to find it. So we're gonna have to grab this other truck. I got trucks everywhere here. I knew that was going to happen. I don't know why I even tried it. Nothing to hook to. Except this goddamn trailer. Change truck. Any other trucks up here? Fuel tanker. There's trailers all over the place here. Go with this one because it has the seismic thing on it anyway. And we will run over to the Alright, see you later, Steelers. Back up. Turn around. On a rescue mission. I just added some time to it by tipping that damn truck over. That's alright. We needed this truck out there anyway. I think. Then we'll have another truck for pulling trailers. roll this one over. I'm gonna break it. Or get it stuck on its way. You know, and I could just detach the trailer from the other thing and use that truck to flip the other truck over, but again, you should have this over there anyway, especially for your first time. Help you locate the parts. I mean, the map runner thing does help, but to find them. Big orange to the red rescue. As I crash and flip over and be like, okay, big yellow to the go get the other truck. I'm gonna come around the other side. Let's go locate the, let's get this other truck out of here first. Not the engine, change the truck. God damn it, see that's why I didn't move that truck yet. Change truck. Going. Okay, so now that I finally we got that part done. Now get this down where it needs to be. Because once you get this other truck in there, you won't be able to get in there. We're going to go around, and we got the other truck in the way. And then you're going to try to squeeze through there, because that'll tip over again. Crap, didn't even need the metal detector. There's a damn plane. Okay. Now, I'm gonna go grab the other truck. What I like to do is back this trailer in there. Legs down. Make sure your legs are down. This thing is very heavy, so you gotta be very careful. Which is why I backed in here instead of don't let it go out on you. Camera angles suck. On the truck. Is it going to be good enough to pack it to the cheese truck? It was. Awesome. So, again, this is the only one that you need this big trailer for. And you could probably literally get away with having without the trailer, but the other two pieces are pretty small. You can get away with not having to have this big trailer for the other pieces. Got some strategically placed rocks for you to have to avoid. But you are going to need this trailer. So, if you are bringing the other parts, I'll show you. Because just having them rest on that flatbed, whether it be the, you know, your Fleet Star or Paystar or your BM-17, whatever one you're using to haul the other pieces. I can get there. They won't register as cargo because they're not strapped down. So you won't be able to take them into the, you know, at the airport over here where we gotta take this piece. So what you gotta do is have this trailer, take those parts, bring them to the airport and set them on this trailer and lock them down on the trailer. And then you can take the trailer to the point and it'll accept it as cargo. Yeah, all we're doing is following the tracks back. We already created a path. So there's this big ass piece. Watch out for the wings, because it does look to get caught on trees. The tail wing. But yeah, you got to pack it on this trailer to be considered cargo. But you don't have to wheel this trailer back and forth every time. Which is a good thing. Slow crawl through the snow. I'm guessing that this plane is pretty heavy. Not to mention the trailer is huge. I'm just going to go back the way I came. Just got to dodge some of these rocks to get the right angle on them so that the trailer doesn't get hung up. It hangs low. I try to go wide, because otherwise you're going to get hung up. And then by doing that, sometimes you get hung up on other areas. So. Looks like we made it through that spot. Okay, off we go. Hey, DJ! With the new trucks? I don't know. I already finished this one. Pretty much. It can be. Like, I've rolled it over a couple times where I had to bring another truck in to tip it back over. Biggest thing is to take your time. It's not a race. Enjoy the game while you got it. I've done it with the other trucks. This does make it a little bit easier. Not really that much. I mean, it is, but it doesn't. Got a nice wide turn on here so we don't catch that wing on the trees over here. This is a tough stretch right here. I honestly don't know what I'm hung up on over here. The tail wing. And on that fucking tree. You just hold it down. Can't back up. Can't go forward. It just needed a little bit. And I am just going all over the place with this trailer. Yeah, it just needed a little tweak. Ugh. All right. Should be able to make it back before we run out of fuel. Okay, now that we got that done, one last tricky part. And that's when we get up to the road over here. You just want to go back basically the same way you came up, so you'll be able to see, you should be able to see your tracks. It's the way you came off the road. Avoid the tree. So what I do is I grab the trailer and then I hook it to one of these poles over here. Not that one. Pull. Pull the trailer up. And off you go. Easy peasy. No, it's a slow crawl back to the, I don't know what you call it again. Nothing. It's an imaginary thing. plane got hit. Tailwind. This is the Veyron D, but I use the, this has a saddle high attachment on it. It's the Veyron D something or other. 53233 JBE. I have all my trucks for this truck. It's just whatever attachments you put on it. So saddle high, saddle low, the crane and the flatbed. That's my, and then I actually have them for logging trucks too, because he went in and added the mod for the log trailers. So then they work really well. So. And like I said, well, we won't, I guess we'll need, we could refuel, but, refuel. What you're going to do, what I do, you don't have to do it the way I do it. One down, two to go. But the other two pieces have to be strapped onto this trailer. Oh shit, I knocked it over. Oh, the plane did. Well, I probably won't even be able to use it for refuel if it's tipped upside down. I got some work ahead of me. So what I do is I park this on the runway over here. I'm gonna pull up next to the fuel trailer and try to tip that back over. Or not. It's a catch, but it isn't gonna. Push it over into the snow. Maybe that will. I didn't think today was gonna be this difficult. Into the snow, which should work. Okay, so pull you out to the side. Brakes, stop the truck. So now we are headed back over. Nope. Yeah, trucks everywhere. Here. Store crane. We're going to head down and we're going to get this other piece of the plane. What I do is I keep looking to the right. You don't need that metal detector thing. Keep looking to the right, you'll see a path. The only other one you might use for the other side. Alright, so here's your path. Doesn't really look like much of a path, but it's a path. Man, I started this in the morning. Make sure your legs are down. Crane legs. That one's bad. Now all we gotta do is haul this back to the So this is the same truck there, DJ. It just has the flatbed on it, the crane. Which comes in very handy for this mission. So you don't have to bring that big trailer over here every time. I want to get this thing over, but I want to get my truck out of this stuff first. She's moving around pretty good. I want to get it tightened up a little bit. She may bounce around a little bit, but she shouldn't fall off. Anyway, if it does, it isn't that heavy. Might as well refuel, right? Probably didn't need it. Probably could have waited till I got to the airport. But we're right here. And keep taking that same path. We know which way to get there. Well, it'll be easier now because this truck, well, this we're not pulling a trailer. Not that we won't get hung up on shit. Maybe even tip over, but. We won't have to get the trailer hung up on shit. Take your time going through here, because like you can see, it's not the flattest. The last thing you want to do is have to rescue yourself out of here. So we have one more trip, and then it's just trailers. Which, even if I don't finish it up on this stream, the reason I didn't rip any of these trailers and get rid of them is because of the fact that I may need some. Well, you definitely need the big fuel tanker. You need this little fuel tanker that's up there, and then there's another fuel tanker. But even if I don't get them all off on the stream, I'll finish them up. And then next episode, which hopefully will be next Saturday, if I'm not doing anything over the 4th of July weekend, I'm not sure what's going on yet. I will be doing whatever, flooded foothills will be the first one. We'll do all the scouting, find all the missions, towers, and upgrades in the first map, which is what I like to do every time in that order. That way, you know, you get all your tasks all discovered, you get all of your upgrades and towers. Then you can just go along and just start doing them all. Alright, here we go. The hill. No, I never tried to do two of these pieces. I might have been able to get that other piece, but I don't know. I don't think it would have stayed on here. Instead of having to go back and get that other piece. And unfortunately, my other truck does not have a crane on it. The seismic one. Otherwise, I wouldn't have had to drive that one over here. But we'll use that one to grab a trailer or something. There's that scout fuel trailer that's over there. And a regular fuel trailer. So I think we can grab both. And we'll haul that back to the trailer store. And then I have two trucks over here. One's going to have to haul. Well, actually, I don't even have the right equipment. I think I need a saddle low to haul that fuel truck here. I almost ran into the tip trailer. Alright, so I never remember which way to put this on here. We'll see if it was right. Got it right, first try. Alright, get some fuel. Not that we need it, but what the hell, it's right here, right? And we're off. Again. You get a highway war down here. He's left. Then it's the fun job of rounding up trailers. Try not to drive into the ocean too far. I'm just looking to see because that other piece is over here. I'd love to be able to go this way, but I think that's going to be a downfall. I think we'll go this way, and then we're going to turn here. Probably going to regret this, but... the other one's right over here. I mean, I got a truck over here to tip me back over if need be, but it's all wood, so you should be able to tip yourself back over for that matter. Watch out for these strategically placed boulders that they make you drive over on an angle, which will just make you tip right half over and ruin your day. Straight. Where am I going? Okay, we're going the right way. That wasn't so bad, was it? Logging missions right here. Well, this is a log station, actually. Taking its width, so I don't have to come back this far. Because the other truck, the seismic one, will grab the fuel tanker and the other scout truck trailer. I'll drag them out with that. Yeah, you can try to go around on the shoreline, and it's close, and I think you could do it, but with these fat balloony tires on this truck, narrow, you're too wide, and you may bounce off. All it takes is one bad move, one rubbery rock or whatever, with these overinflated tires, and you're screwed. So, best bet is just to go through the shiznit and up and around. Same worn out path that we've been running. But we did the last piece. So the missions will be done except for logging, which again I will be coming back later to do. As soon as we get Wisconsin and I unlock that truck, which is when I do all of the towers and stuff, and then I'll find that truck. And then we'll go back and we'll go back to Michigan and we'll do all the logging and keep going all the way through and get up to Wisconsin again, and we'll finish missions and then do logging again at the end, and then we can continue on. Ooh, hello. Which is even the same thing. I did the same thing on my other account, one that I just play on. I don't stream on it. Okay, we're coming down to the ice. The poor little fuel trailer getting a crap beat out of it. We're at 1 hour and 8 minutes total time for this mission so far. And I guarantee it would have been longer had I had that big trailer. To do that whole thing with the big trailer. Back and forth. But 1 hour and 8 minutes isn't too bad. By the time we get there, it'll probably be 1 hour and 10 minutes. So about 23 minutes for each piece, give or take. I gotta remember how to put this one on the truck. If it's tip of the wing, done. Okay, so what do we have for trailers? We got trucks everywhere. We have a fuel carrier trailer, which is up here, which we're going to be grabbing with this truck, and we're going to grab this one. So that's two. But first things first, let's take this big ass trailer. Back to the garage, or back to the trailer store. Because we do not need it anymore. the grind. And again, I have more than enough money that I wouldn't have to do this, but it's just a thing that I'd have to do for myself. I don't even know where all the damn trucks are. They're scattered around the map. I mean, so I might have some by other trailer that I don't want to worry about as much. There was another truck at the airport back there, which I don't think I'll need to do that one. I can recover that one back because I need to bring a truck with the saddle low on it to grab that trailer. And then there's another trailer at the trailer store. It's big like this. It has to be. You have to use this truck, so. one there. We'll take that one. Get rid of that one. We'll grab this little scout trailer. We can recover this truck. What else we got? We have this truck over here. These don't move, these cabins here, so. There's a scout trailer there. One, two, three, four, five, six left. So let's count them up. We got one on the truck. Two would be this one. Three is here. Four is up there. Five is on the thing at the airport. Six. Where is number six? Not this one. That one. Of course, that's what I said. Along the side of the path. That one. Yeah. That one. That one. Oh, okay, yeah, that one. Yeah, so not too bad. What we'll do is we'll go take this one. And I'm gonna bring it back up again. We'll go get that other trailer. We'll haul that one out. With this one, we'll grab that little scout trailer. Actually, I'll probably use this truck once I'm done to get the trailer and haul it over and get that last fuel trailer. Big fuel trailer.
the road.
Trying to take a shortcut, didn't work so well. That's why I was trying to turn that trailer around. Come on, Cletus. Sometimes it's just better off not driving with any lights. It's, at least in my eye, bug the hell out of me when I'm trying to drive in here. It's like it's too bright. It's like they have brights or no headlights. They don't have just dims. Thank you. this one hooked up. I didn't figure it would stay in there, so whatever happened, happened. This truck would just stay straight. Hit the button. believe after all of that, this thing is still on its wheels. Ain't fun unless you're breaking shit. Jesus. Looks like I'm gonna be limping back. Well, it must be getting close to daylight. Pretty dear to see now. Don't hear anything. That's because I had my mute. my microphone turned off. Yeah. So anyway, yeah, I did everything in an hour, 3 missions, and then the rest has been trailer. I was AFK for a little bit. Had some business to take care of. That's trailer. Well, yeah, doing the trailers didn't take long. I doubled up on a few of them. But I'm not gonna, what do you call it? I'm not jumping over. I'm gonna move everything over to that map, but I'm not gonna do anything over there. Except pull the stuff out of the garages and stuff. Okay, so all that's left is the 2 portable cabins, which we can't do anything with anyway, and they're over here. So it doesn't pay to worry about them. So, mission-wise, I'll double-check. I believe these are all just logging missions, which we will come back to later. That's it. So, off we go to the global map, to the Yukon. Go to the garage. What we're gonna do is we're gonna pull out what we need: scout truck, saddle high truck, and a flatbed truck with a crane. That's all we'll need in the beginning. Eventually we're gonna need other ones, but yeah. I gotta make my phone call yet. Okay, truck storage. We don't need this. We'll need that. Welcome to the Yukon. Yay! This is where the game changes, guys. This is where... Yeah, saddle low. That's what this is. Saddle low and a flatbed and a... That's what I said. I won't need the saddle high right away. Saddle low, flatbed, and a scout truck. Nope, I don't want a storage. I got enough freaking trucks. I found some different tires that I like, I think, on here, so... And one more. Hey, George. Just finished work. Nice. I just finished a Mondra. Truck storage. flatbed and a crane. That's it. So we are now done with all of that. So I don't, again, we have all of this to discover. So that'll be next week, hopefully, depending upon my schedule. We got four towers, I forget how many upgrades, and we will find all the missions. Tasks, I should say. And then we'll move again. So anyway, I hope everybody enjoyed the stream. You had a lovely Yuka. I hope everybody enjoyed the stream. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you guys on the next one. Bye, everybody.